Right now, the AI is accessible by ordinary people. Any user that have internet connection can benefit from the AI technology right now. But the thing is, the more exciting part is not the ChatGPT. It's this one. It is this one behind the scene. I think I can guess that you never saw about this playground. This is a tool from OpenAI, who is the owner of the ChatGPT. And playground, this tool is the technology behind the scene of the ChatGPT. But for the ChatGPT, they focus to serve ordinary people. So the thing is that you can ask the ChatGPT and get the answer at ChatGPT, but you can do just like that and get the answer. Ask and get the answer. You can just do like that. You cannot customize anything, and you cannot build a tool based on the ChatGPT itself. But behind the scene, they have a playground that allow programmers to connect to them and use the same technology behind the scene of the ChatGPT, the same technology that ChatGPT use. We can access it by being a programmer. But I'm not saying you have to be trained to be a programmer. Don't go that way. It's really headache. Don't be a programmer. For this class, we talk about entrepreneur, right? So this program means that as an entrepreneur, we can hire programmer cheap to create AI tools. Cheap, I can tell you cheap. Only 100 or 200 US dollar, you can have a small AI app if the programmer know how to use this one. So actually, this is the game changing for the AI world, because with the playground, we can build we can customize, or we can build an AI tools that work better than ChatGPT. And we will focus this in this masterclass. Okay? So right now, I'm going to summarize that in the third phase. It's right now, the AI is highly accessible by novice developers. You don't need to hire advanced developers. Just a junior developer or programmers, then it's okay. They can do this. I will show you how easy it is. So in the next phase, it's going to be the next phase, but we don't know how long. It's the fourth phase. The next phase is, we call the AI the AGI. Artificial General Intelligence. It's gonna be as smart as human. But when? We don't know how long. I name it connected and autonomous. That means when we move to the fourth phase, the AI now will be able to connect to everything. Currently, you can see, right, that ChatGPT, you can ask and get the question, right? But they still cannot command any other service. Just like if we want to book a flight, book a hotel, we cannot do that in ChatGPT. Right now, it's really close to be done, but they have to be done via ChatGPT plugin. But it's not close to the completion yet, still far. So in the next phase, everything will be connected, just like we can command the AI to book us some flight that to go to Bangkok. I want to travel about 1 week. And then I want to have a 5-star hotels, and then let it do the job. They will think the plan. They will do the job. It will be that way in the fourth phase. Okay, so it's a guess game right now that which phase will be the peak time, will be the prime time. But for me personally, I think it's the current phase that's gonna be the prime time. As you can see, if you follow the news about the ChatGPT, right, the OpenAI company, they move so fast. They try to move the current phase to the fourth phase. You might heard about the custom GPT, GPT store, or something like that, OpenAI. But yeah, it means that they're going to move fast, and they're trying to do the prime time, to make it the prime time. So we need to hurry. We need to hurry. In order for us to follow the game, in order for us to follow the game closely, we need to know the key players in the AI world first. Let me show you this chart. At the left side, these are all the big investor right now. And at the right side, these are AI companies that is working very well right now. Actually, if you have enough time, you can follow them all. But I have narrowed it down. From this chart, you can see that OpenAI, right? You guys familiar with OpenAI, right? ChatGPT. OpenAI have been invested by Microsoft solely. Actually, there are another investor, but just a few investors, small investor. But for the big company, for the big investor, it's only Microsoft. The next one that we will mention about is that Cohere, just like it, Cohere, is another good AI company, have been invested by NVIDIA and Salesforce. So actually, at the left side, I suggest that you can go to download Google News, the mobile application, and then try to search about the company name, right? Just like Google, and then followed by the keyword AI to keep track on the news about them. Because AI is moving very fast, I suggest you to download the Google News app and then search by this term, the investor keyword, and then followed by AI. And then keep reading, and it will inject you more news about AI to keep you on track. So now we're gonna try to build our first AI tools. Then let's begin the tools creators 101. So to build an AI tools, we should begin with the problem first. What's your problem? And can we solve that with ChatGPT? This is the most easiest way to build an AI apps. If you have a problem that can be solved by ChatGPT, it's gonna be very easy to build one. So let me show you, let me demonstrate you the first one first. We're doing a POD, a print on demand business, right? And in print on demand business, we have to think out of the quote on the mark, to be a good quote that people like. Because if people like the quote, people buy stuff. If people don't like the quote, people don't buy stuff. And our problem is this: we can't think of a new quote every day. So you can guess we use ChatGPT, right? Yeah. To think out of the quote for us. And we got a lot of quote. So let's try to use ChatGPT for this. You want me to show how to use that in the playground?
Yes.
Better, right? Better than the ChatGPT. So let's try to play with the playground. So the problem of us is that we can't think out of the quote every day. So we can play the playground like this. At the left side, we can program that to force that the AI that they can think of what it be. Just like I want the AI to act like you are an expertise on print on demand e-commerce. And you know how to think highly creative quotes all day long or something like that. Yeah. And then we can chat with them, with this the user, this one. The message is that write me a funny, not a, let's say 10 funny and highly creative quote to be print on my coffee mug. So, let's say we target to sell to the nurse. So nurse, so when nurse saw the quote, they going to buy our mug. And then we can pick the model that we will force the AI to use the LLM model. So I pick this. This is where you can see that even you don't pay for the ChatGPT Plus, you still can access to the GPT-4. You don't need to pay for the ChatGPT Plus to use. Then I click on submit. Then they're gonna write us 10 funny and highly creative quote. Let's see if it's funny or not. I don't need an inspiration quote. I need caffeine. Yeah, it's funny, right? It's funny, right? Keep calm and sip on coffee, of course. There is a time and place for decaf. Never in the trash. Yeah, it's funny. ChatGPT is very good at funny stuff. And yeah, now, right now, we know that we can solve the problem with this prompt, right? If we know how to prompt to solve the problem, then we can keep this prompt and turn it to our AI apps. I will show you the first one. You don't need to follow because I will let you try on the next one. This one I will show you first too, so you can know the step.